Hi guys, I'm KD Kwan from Taste of Asian Food. Imagine how it tastes like when this can of Coca-Cola is concentrated into just a few tablespoons. That is what you expect when it comes to Coca-Cola chicken. I remember it was in the 90s in Asia, and it was a hit of this Coca-Cola chicken with a legion of fans, mainly the youngsters. Now the craze might have subsided by now, but it is still one of the popular hybrid Chinese dishes offered in the restaurants. Now, some say that it was invented by the Chinese abroad. They can't find the ingredients and they therefore use Coca-Cola as one of the substitutes. And some other people said it was originated from Shandong province. And despite the obscure origin, the secret ingredients in Coca-Cola match the flavor of the chicken and eventually evolved into a popular dish among the Chinese households. In this video, I want to show you how to make Coca-Cola chicken. Let's follow me. Coca-Cola chicken is usually prepared with chicken wings, although other cuts are equally suitable. There are numerous versions of the Coca-Cola chicken. I have seen some interpretation is to brine the chicken with Coca-Cola and coat it with batter and deep fry. In this video, I will explain how to prepare it with the most common method among the Chinese, that is to braise the chicken. Cut the chicken wing into two by sliding the knife into the joint in between. Just add a little bit of force and it will separate into two. The chicken wings are only seasoned with salt and pepper. There's no need to add soy sauce or oyster sauce as we will not marinate the chicken. Since we're gonna braise the chicken, the flavor has sufficient time to penetrate deep into the chicken meat, which makes marination becomes irrelevant. Mix the chicken with the salt and pepper, then set it aside and move on to prepare the aromatics. I will braise the chicken by using the traditional Chinese method. That means I need some ginger, garlic, and scallion. Cut the scallion into short sections, whereas the ginger and the garlic are into slices. You can add some dry chili to the braising liquid if you want it to make it spicy. However, Coca-Cola chicken is popular among the kids, so you can leave it out to make it appeal to everybody in the family. Pan-fried chicken is an essential step to bring out the flavor. It creates the aroma due to the heat generated in the pan through Maillard reaction, which it does not happen in braising. Pan-fried chicken also helps to tighten the skin, and as a result, the skin will be moist and waxy and will not detach from the meat during stewing. You can either use a well-seasoned cast iron pan or a non-stick pan to pan-fry the chicken. I find that both work well. When both sides of the chickens are nicely brown, remove it from the pan and set it aside. Now heat some oil in a clean pan and saute the dry chili, ginger, garlic, and scallion until aromatic. Once you can smell the aroma, return the chicken to the pan. Add a can of Coca-Cola to the pan and wait until it starts to boil. You know, traditional braised chicken always includes some rock sugar in the recipe. And since Coca-Cola contains sugar, there's no need to add any sugar in this recipe. And the sugar helps to form a thick, glossy sheen on the surface.
And that's why you need to use the original Coca-Cola to prepare the dish. Furthermore, Diet Coke or Zero Coke contains aspartame as the sweetener. Aspartame will break down when heated and therefore is not suitable for cooking. Also season with some light soy sauce, dark soy sauce, and some sesame oil. And also some Shaoxing wine. If you want to use some spices, I suggest using cinnamon bark and star anise. You can add both to the braising liquid, and a small amount is sufficient as it should not overshadow the taste of Coca-Cola. You may consider using more than one can of Coca-Cola for 1 kilogram of chicken to get a more intense flavor. I'm using one can, and it takes about 20 to 30 minutes to reduce to a thick gravy. By that time, the chicken wings are already tender and soft. If you are using more than one can, say 1.5 cans of Coca-Cola, you may need to remove the chicken halfway, say at about 30 minutes, to remove the chicken so that it will not become too soft and falling off the bone. Then reduce the remaining braising liquid into the thick gravy until it is able to coat a metal spoon. And then return the chicken back to the pan. Glaze the chicken with the thick gravy to form a glossy sheen. Once it is done, remove from the pan and put it onto a serving plate. Sprinkle with some white sesame seeds and garnish with some cut scallion and serve.
That's how to make Coca-Cola chicken, and I hope you will try at home one day. If you want to get the recipe, I've included it in the description right below the video. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button, tap the notification bell, and give me a like. I will see you again in some other similar video very soon in the future, and bye for now.